We all know it can just be a major headache if you have to go to the DMV to do just about anything. And now with the threats to close the Milford branch, things could get worse. News 8's Serena Marshall live tonight in Milford with what people are dealing with. And Serena, a lot of people in Connecticut look at the DMV just like getting a root canal. Pretty painful.
Yeah, and it's, you know, this location closed an hour ago and people are still inside waiting. And after those AAA locations closed down, it means the state DMV operating out of this city building is the only one within 10 miles of Milford. Waiting in line at the DMV is never a pleasant experience.
I have no choice. Yes, I have to stay. If I want to drive my car, I have to stay.
But add in limited hours and the AAA closures and you get this.
2 hours.
About an hour, a little over an hour.
So far, I've been here 45 minutes.
And many, like Jerome Sonia, don't have a choice.
If I don't have my license tomorrow, I'm in jeopardy of a job position.
But it's not just the inconvenience. The DMV lines also interrupting business as usual for city employees.
People are constantly knocking on our door because they want to ask us questions. And like I said, we have nothing to do with DMV. But we try to help out the best we can.
From blocking the halls to limited parking. The Milford mayor telling us just today he emailed the DMV commissioner about the issue and offering solutions, like using this bigger room.
Get people out of the hallway.
Or a system without lines, notifying people by text when it's their turn. And if nothing can be agreed, it could mean closing the location completely. The DMV saying they hope to have a plan in place very shortly and appreciate the mayor's patience as together they work through alternative options. Well, the state and the city work something out. Frustration builds.
I said, oh, too many people are leaving. I don't have time.
45 minutes after we first met Jerome.
At least now we're in the same zip code.
Now, the biggest problem is staffing and increasing hours. And of course, both would require more money from an already cash-strapped state. In Milford, Serena Marshall, Channel 8.